as extreme care in this situation, with the safety of yourself and others as the priority.
Something completely useful on ABC Radio Brisbane and Queensland.
You're with Katherine Feeney on ABC Radio Brisbane and Queensland.
It is 3:15 and it's Monday, and I'm just very excited because Peter Racey is back in the studio. Peter, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Kath. Good afternoon, listeners.
Now, you, of course, are one of the key figures in the Expo 88 anniversary celebrations. You've been a key figure in the whole Expo 88 story, really, and I'm kind of talking a lot because I'm a little bit disturbed by what you've brought with you today. It's making me nervous, Peter Racey. You've got an arm with you.
Well, yes, I picked it up this morning.
A detached arm. Just hanging on. You've come in and give us a hand, literally and figuratively speaking. What's going on?
Well, it is one of the pieces that are being recast in the memory of Expo 88. And Kath, this particular piece is on its way into the John Oxley Library because John and Judy Underwood have very kindly agreed to donate a lot of their original records recording the production of all those Expo 88 art pieces. And it will really be a coup. And so one of our Facebook followers thought there'd be nothing better than to make a donation and give a bit of a hand to the 30th celebration. And this is it.
This is it indeed. Donations and arms.
Exactly. We need lots more arms, actually.
Goodness me. Now, Peter Racey, you are the acting chair of a community group that is coordinating the 30th anniversary of Expo, and you've basically been pulling together all of the various elements that formed this incredible extravaganza that we did have in 1988, an extravaganza, sadly, that I missed out on completely, but one that I'm hoping to kind of pay tribute to with a bit of a party here at Afternoons. We want to take the show outside, put it down on South Bank, recreate some aspects of Expo.
And I'm hoping to join you.
Excellent. Good, good. What, in your mind, are the top five essential Expo elements that we must include as part of our broadcast?
Well, you've already named one of those, the Fest House.
Right.
Secondly, New Zealand ice cream, without a shadow of a doubt.
Okay.
I'm hoping that in the top five ends up Art Buster pieces, the 62 or roughly thereabouts, beautiful pieces made in Brisbane, made by Brisbaneites. The models were Brisbaneites. You couldn't find any more of a Brisbane connection to Expo 88 than the Art Buster pieces.
They're the statues, the human
the
statues.
White human statues,
the
of
hand.
Which I have a representative hand in my hand.
We'll get Superstar producer Annie Papalotto to tweet out a photograph of you in this hand because it's something that needs to be seen to be believed. But before we get the rest of your top five elements, just staying with the Art Busters statues, what can you tell me about the Sleeman Sports Complex? You've got your eyes set on a figure out there.
Well, yes, there's the skaters out there. And about June of last year, via my local member who's Di Farmer, I wrote to the Premier asking about that particular piece because I was sort of worried about the public safety aspect of it. And just prior to the saving of the Australia signs, which went off like a rocket in social media.
Oh, yes.
It was incredible, the response
incredible.
To that. Absolutely
yep.
amazing. One of our followers put up some pictures of that, and it reminded me that I should go back out and have a look, of which I have done so, and I'm now told by the powers that be that, yes, it does look a bit run down mm-hmm. and a little bit at risk, but, you know, they've checked it out. It appears to be safe and secure, and I'm hoping that that's the case because it doesn't look like that to my untrained eye, but I'm not a structural engineer by any stretch of the imagination. And the Facebook experience, just going back to the saving of the Expo signs, you know, for the 2013, I tried to save those and I had them going down to the Australian Museum. The ACT government said, no, not on Yanelli. They're going to be pollution on the foreshore of Lake Burley Griffith, out to Longreach, to the Hall of Fame, where the Queen opened the Hall of Fame the day prior to Expo. Sorry, no, our charter won't let us accept anything that's not bush related. And I was just running around in circles and I finally thought I'd had the issue solved by having it, you know, as a major entrance statement to the Brisbane Airport. And lo and behold, things didn't quite work out, the timing wasn't quite right. And this time, thankfully for me, no intervention, no nothing. A very smart young student out at the Athena College put a Facebook page up and it fired. Craig and Rebecca's show just took the issue, and within 24 hours, there's a home for it.
There's a home for the Caboolture, up in Caboolture.
Exactly. And I'm speaking to them today, and they've solved another problem because I actually had left over from the 25th two spotlights they're searchlights, they're a metre by a metre, they are huge, left over as a gift to us, and they've been stored up in the Queensland Maritime Museum, and they've agreed to take those. Again, social media post, bang.
Everyone coming together.
Oh, it's really a total and utter surprise.
I just think it's brilliant. Recreating Expo, tracking down all those special elements, the pieces, the stories, the experiences, because it was an event that really had a massive influence over the lives of so many people, especially if you were lucky enough to get down to Expo 88 in the time that it took over what is now South Bank. Just, Peter Racey, on the subject of the South Bank, though, we were looking at some maps while we were putting together a bit of what we want to do for the outside broadcast is have the first part of the show as a bit of a tour around some of the old pavilions, sites as they are today, because the Fest House, the Munich Fest House, which will be a feature of this tour, is basically where the ABC studio is right now.
The spirit lives on.
It does. So obviously it's on the tour. What else should be on the tour? The other four elements, that remains to be seen. We'd love to get your feedback on this, both on the Facebook page, ABC Radio Brisbane Facebook. We've got some great comments coming through at the moment. But if you'd like to call in and suggest the other four elements that simply must be included on this Expo 88 anniversary tour.
The pagoda.
Call now. The Nepalese pagoda. Exactly.
1-300-222-612.
Well, pause that thought for one moment, Peter Racey, because when we were looking at the maps and we were thinking, okay, this is the map of the old Expo site, this is the map of South Bank now, we were overlaying the two of them to see what was what, we saw written on the map that there was a time capsule.
Ah, yes, I did notice that there was a Facebook page, and that is a huge mystery. I mean,
so where is this time capsule?
You know, we'll have to get out a metal detector, I think, and go searching.
Because we think it was sort of, Peter Gooch had a look, Annie Papalato had a look, we reckon it's down near the Brisbane, where the Brisbane sign is now, roughly, in the cultural forecourt area.
A little bit further up, I might think, but if that is the case, then it's well and truly being excavated, because that car park wasn't there during Expo.
So you reckon that the Expo time capsule might have been dug up already?
Don't know. I would hate to spoil a good mystery.
1-300-222-612 if you've got any insight as to the Expo 88 time capsule that was featured on the old map, so it definitely was buried. Do you remember, was there any pomp and ceremony attached to this burial?
No,
Peter
Racey. I've come to realise.
Are you sure? You're a man of mystery. Are you keeping a bit secret?
No, honest scout's honour.
All right then. Okay. Your Facebook comments, though, on the idea of what else we should include on the Expo 88 extravaganza tour. Basically, everyone agrees that the New Zealand Pavilion, Canada, and Italy. So that takes us to four things. Now, were they particularly spectacular, Canada, Italy, New Zealand? You've already said that you're a fan of the Kiwis.
Well, the
Peter
Kiwi
Racey.
Ice cream, yes.
Yeah, okay.
Yes.
What did the Canadians have and the Italians?
They had the Inukshuk.
What's that?
Well, it's an amazing piece of indigenous sculpture that's at in Gregory Terrace on the bikeway.
Oh, okay. So do you think that it'd be worth bringing back a bit of the Canadian Pavilion?
I do indeed.
Okay, I'll add it to the list. And before we let you go, the Italians, what did they have that was so special?
Lots of pasta, I assume.
Yeah, righto.
And do you know that the Italian Pavilion is still in existence and it's on the way to Sydney? And I just can't remember the little town that it's situated in. I've driven past it hundreds of times, and I've been into the pavilion dozens of times. And they still have some Expo 88 memorabilia on display, one of which was Da Vinci's car. It was a reproduction, and it's just an amazing bit of kit.
Okay, excellent. Well, we hope to have the tour details finalised by the end of the week so we can start putting this party together ahead of April 30. It's going to be a spectacular day. Peter Racey, thank you for coming in and giving us a
helping hand.
Peter Racy. Not quite from 1988, but from the 80s, and we will be